It's one thing to just attach watch hands to movements, but setting watch hands with perfect alignment is a completely different story. With a quality movement like the 9075, I think it's worth the effort. Most of the techniques covered in this video will work for other movements as well, such as the Seiko SR34 or the TMI NH34. Before we do anything, let's make sure that we have a good dial installation. With an off-center dial, you'll realize later that it's impossible to get good hand alignments. I like to use the center dial hole to check and see if the dial is installed correctly. And if I need to, I would push the dial slightly to adjust and center it. Now let's secure the movement. There are a couple ways to do this. If you have one of these movement holders or our hand installation assisting tool, this should give you the best setup. But if you don't have access to these tools, the case back of the watch itself, along with the movement holder, should give you a very good support. Okay, now let's take a look at the posts of your movement with a loop. Pay special attention to this smallest post right here. Be extra careful not to bend this throughout the hand installation process. Now, onto hand setting tools. We set the GMT hand first, the hour hand, the minute hand, and then the second hand. The tips of your hand setting tools come with opening of different sizes. For each of the watch hands, select the one with an opening smaller than the post you're working on, but larger than the next post. So for example, for the GMT hand, you need one smaller than the GMT hand post, but larger than the hour hand post. This will allow you to push the hand all the way down and have the post stop you at the correct height. This is how it looks with the hour hand and the minute hand. Let's begin setting the GMT hand. Pull the crown all the way out and you should be at the time setting position. Rotate the crown counterclockwise for MIYOTA and clockwise for Seiko to set the time forward. It could be quite a few turns as there are 24 hours in a day. Once the date starts to transition, slow down. We want to stop right here when the date change is completed. Not over and then back. If I go over by mistake, I always set it forward again by 24 hours. Okay, now let us loosely attach the GMT hand. You can pick up the watch hands with either a pair of tweezers or Rodico. For all watch hands, the tubes point downward. So we are going to install it like this, aligning it to 12 o'clock. Do not rotate the tool when pressing down, and press down just enough so that it doesn't fall off. Now set the time forward again and see if the date transitions when the GMT hand is pointing at midnight. This is pretty good. Now any watch will have misalignment once you look at it close enough. So what is good enough? That's up to you to decide. If you want to reattempt, simply remove the watch hands and repeat the steps. Just a quick note on watch hand removal. GMT hands can quite often sit very low to the dial and dial protectors may not work at all. I like to use the inside of Ziploc bags for dial protection when removing the watch hands. After you have achieved perfect alignment, you can now set the watch hand to the correct height. Remember to keep the tool as vertical as possible. For most watches, with the correct tool, you can push the hand all the way down until the post stops you. You should be able to see the top of the post at a similar level as the top of the watch hand. This is the same later on for the hour and minute hand. It's a general rule that you want to set your watch hands as low as possible without touching the components below and as level as possible, so not tilting up or down. This will leave you with more space for the components above. If your watch hand ends up tilting upward a little bit, you can adjust it slightly by angling the tool like this. And if your watch hand is tilting downward, I would use one of these to gently pull up the watch hand. This adjustment method works for the hour and minute hand as well. Now, onto the hour hand. Set the time forward until it's pointing at 6, or 12 if you have a 24-hour dial. Now, if you go over, do not just set the time backward and then install the hour hand. You want to stop right there, choose the correct tool, and then set the hour hand loosely. This is because of gear slack. Setting the time forward and backward never results in the same alignment. This situation is a little bit worse for entry-level movements like the NH34. Now let's check the alignment. I like to check the alignment of the watch hands at these positions. For NH34 with plastic dial holes and a little bit more gear slack, I would say this is a best effort situation. But for 9075, I can consistently achieve alignments like this. If your alignment is not good enough, you can remove the hour hand and retry. This is also why you want to set the hands loosely when you initially align the watch hands. Once you're satisfied with the alignment, set the watch hand to the correct height and make sure it's level. Onto the minute hand. To avoid involving irrelevant components such as the date complication, we are going to set the minute hand at noon instead of midnight. By now you should know the drill. Set the time forward to align. Choose the right tool and then loosely attach the minute hand. Let's check the alignment. This looks good. There is one extra check that you can perform here. Set the time forward until the date transitions. For a quality installation, the date transition should happen between midnight and 5 minutes past midnight. So let's see how I did here. Right at 5 minutes. Could have done better, but this is pretty good. With a good enough alignment, now let's set the minute hand down to the correct height and make sure that it's level. Now we can perform the final check. If you align the watch hands correctly, this can be immensely satisfying. This is it for this part of watch hand installation. Now it's a very good time to take a break before we proceed to install the second hand.